Banks got the romantic, you know, long dinner, one-on-one, you know, wine and food and dancing and, you know, the perfect romantic date on a rooftop.
I was ecstatic. You know, I was always worried that the fun things that everybody would, you know, that were available to do on the dates, I wouldn't be able to do because of my arm. So I always felt like I was kind of at a disadvantage at all time.
Banks and I had such a lovely time. And I just remember having the most exquisite meal. It was like a true moment. Like we were having a true moment. And I think it was one of the points in the show where I just completely forgot that there were any cameras. It was just us two in the room. It was nothing else, nobody else was there.
She was supposed to come back and have strawberries with either Sharif, I think it was Sharif or Chad. And our date, they just was going so well that they didn't want to interrupt it and stop it. So they didn't stop it. So it just continued all through the night. And then I came back and laid in bed with her for a little bit.
The date in San Francisco, I got completely robbed.
Because Banks's dinner went so well that they ended up, you know, busting into Chris's time.
We were supposed to have, you know, rooftop, romantic, you know, view of the city, and, you know, it sounded like, oh, that sounds like a pretty good date.
I get the trolley date, which, you know, is just us on a trolley for like 5 or 10 minutes with, you know, 50 other San Franciscans. And I just felt I got screwed in that whole deal.
I felt really bad because with the date with Sharif, like it was really hard to hear. Granted, we were the only two on this trolley, but like just with the noise, the city noise, and trying to have it be like a romantic date, I don't know, it was just kind of hard.
Trolley ride with Sharif guy, it was just